Hey everybody, Joel the Pirate here. Welcome back to the apocalypse. I'm putting on some final touches here. Oh, I'm stuck. Putting some final touches here on the old funnel of death, or at least working on the last few layers of it here. Let me repair all this up, and you can get a better idea of what it's looking like here. I have gone through so much concrete, so much wood, so... In fact, how am I doing? Ooh, I'm about out. So now's a good time as any to actually go down below and show you what it is. Or show you what I'm doing here. One more. Yes. And did I have enough for... Ooh, I had enough for one more thing. Okay. Let me get around here. You know what? Let's put you there so I can... talk to the people and show them what's what. Okay, so the last time I left you, I was just down below that last layer of ramps there and working my way up. So I've gotten this set of ramps. Let's backtrack a little. Remember when I said I was going to leave the corners open so that they could fall through? Well, that isn't going to work with the funnel design. Had I just done flat slabby walls, then that would have worked. But no, here I've got to use these little corner things. Anyway, so yeah. I got this this funnel done, and then this funnel, and now I'm going on the outside edge here, and then this last part of the funnel of death is all going to be attached to the back wall, like the outside wall. So we'll have like a three-stage funnel. We'll have this first section, which will funnel them onto these ramps, and then they'll fall down onto those ramps, and then they'll fall down into the center, into the 9x9 area. And let me get down here. This little staircase is pretty damn nice. I think I'm going to leave it in place. I've already started repairing up some of it. But I think I'm going to leave it just in case I ever do have to get up here and do any repairs to anything. And yeah, I'll light it up because it's awful damn... awful damn dark. But I'll get some torches up in here. And hopefully that does a thing. So yeah, here's where we're looking at from down here. It's pretty sweet. I'm actually pretty happy with the way it's turning out. And yeah, I definitely have to do something with these walls. These are annoying me, like, mostly because of crap like this, the way the voxels generate in there. But I love my brick walls so much that I'm going to continue to do those. Let's grab a couple 3,000 wood there. How are we doing on... Ooh, this thing's done finally. Sure, we'll take that. Let me grab that out of there. And shut up, dog. I'm talking to the people. I'll have to make some more cement there. Maybe I'll have to make some more cement. Yeah, I'll probably have to make some more cement. Yeah, that's going to be a thing. I'll have to make more. But let's go ahead and go back up there, and maybe I can get a little bit more done. I'm anxious to try this thing out. We've got the day 70 horde coming. So maybe we'll try that out with the day 70 horde. I'll just park my butt down at the bottom there, and then hopefully they will track to me and then fall down the hole. That would be cool. Hopefully they won't track to the base. They should track to me. I believe that's how it works. I don't recall. And I'm going to have to leave this open temporarily so that I can get up to the level I'm working on, which is going to be interesting. I'm going to have to do a lot of work from up above. I just want to get these first couple layers in, and then I will, I got to work my way around. And then I will load myself up with enough supplies that I can do the entire thing from down here all the way to the tippy top without having to go back down, and then I can close off that ladder. That's the plan anyway. Let's go ahead and close off this first section here, or this last little section, and then we will take a break so I can work. Literally, because I have to go to work. All play and no work makes Joe a poor boy. So, yeah. I think that's how that goes. This is so tedious. I wish I had a nail gun. And, yeah, I think after the day 70 horde, we've done enough building for a little while. I think it's time to head out to the real world. I think I can get one more in here without it affecting the ladder. Let's see here. Nope. That's going to have to be it. Okay. There we go. And then I will just go ahead and do the next layer, et cetera, et cetera. Just working my way around. That's all I've got left to do is just finish this up. So, yeah, I'm going to go ahead and finish this up, and then we may end up waiting for the day 70 horde. It depends, actually, because, like I said, I have to make up some more concrete, so that may take time. That may take a day or so for me to finish up enough or to get enough concrete to finish this all up. You wouldn't believe it, but this is what 1,000 rebar looks like. That's about how many I've used so far on this whole thing is I think I'm on my second stack right now, so, yeah. All right. Well, I'm going to go ahead and try and get this buttoned up. And I do have some stuff up top I want to do, too. So we will dress up the lip and make it kind of pretty up there, too. So, yep, hang on, and we'll be back. Well, it's been a long time since we've seen what the tree farm looked like after a harvest there. But, yeah, it was necessary to harvest latrines. And this place looks naked. I'm telling you what, I'm so used to seeing those trees there that it really looks strange without it. But I do have all the wood giggity, that I am going to need to finish this thing up. Actually, I probably got enough wood that I'm going to be able to finish up the apocalypse with it. If I have to harvest that tree farm one more time, I'm going to be building something monstrously mega huge. So, yeah, here's where we're at so far. Look at all this goddamn wood. This is funny as all hell. I love that tree farm. It's the best. It's the best around. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 40. 44,000 wood. Yeah, we'll make do. Yeah, we'll make do with 44,000 wood. Now, I should have a bunch of concrete somewhere. How the hell are you concrete? Hey, concrete. Found it. Or cement, rather. Excuse me. Which needs to go up in here. And, aha. Yes, and I still have concrete cooking. And I still have concrete here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's take 5. And where is yes, get my rebar, get my ramps, and are we good? I think we're good. All right, so let's go ahead and get on up to the thing. And you guys are giving me all kinds of crap about this thing. I'm telling you what, it's on a wood floor. Holy crap, it's on a wood floor. Guess what? It's not doing anything. It's not hurting anything. It's fine. Don't worry. Don't worry. It's fine. And I will eventually put stairs in here instead of all these damn wood frames because these are annoying as all. And here we go. Now, I will have to button this area up before it's all said and done, and this is all temporary, but it gets me out here to where I need to be, and we are almost done with this damn thing. Yeah, you can see that's it, ground level right there, and woo-wee, look at all that death and destruction down there. I did have a couple of zombies, a wandering horde, show up. What was it on? Yeah, it was on day 68 yesterday. Oh, by the way, hey, today is day 69. Giggity. And, yeah, so I had a couple zombies show up on day 68. They did fall. They did not like the falling. Now, had I just made these smooth slabbed sides, I suspect there would have been a lot more fall damage going on there. You know, according to Mad Mole, they took fall damage out of the game, but telling you what, when these guys fall all the way down there, they take a bunch of damn damage. That's all there is to it. So, yeah. If you guys are going to design something quite like this or exactly like this, I would suggest a full funnel. I would not suggest this three-tiered thing. That's just me. It, yeah. I think fall damage is still your buddy. in this game. What? Oh, weird. Thought I heard an Enderman. Probably my brain playing tricks on me. Too much beer. I had a very long, long day at work. I had to go in early, I had to work a split shift. Let me put it that way. So I had to go in 4 hours early, which for somebody who works a normal day job, imagine just getting up 4 hours early and going into work. Well, imagine getting up 6 hours early and going into work 4 hours early, you know. So, yeah, I'm like super, I don't know, punchy right now. Had a hell of a day. I had to get, as some of you know, some of you don't know, I work in a factory where we produce parts for airplane engines. And I had to get certified. Phone going off. I had to get certified today so that I don't always have to have somebody watching over my shoulder and making sure that I'm doing stuff the right way, etc., etc. It's just a natural process. Of course, I did pass because, you know, yay, I'm good. But yeah, so I had to get up early to go in because, you know, we wouldn't want the people on the day shift to have to stay late or anything. You know, that would be a crime. No, we'll make the night people come in early. Yeah. I'm not bitter or jaded or anything. No, not at all. Not at all. No, I'm fine, though. I got, you know, I got off early, so I'm able to goof around and do a little bit. We're doing a little bit overtime here and there because, you know, demand is high for things that I do. I can't discuss what it is that I do. But, yeah, demand is a little bit high right now. So, yeah, they wanted to get me certified so that I can work unsupervised and just blow it out, you know, blow parts out. Is that what I want to say? I don't know. Blow parts out sounds really dirty. But, what we got to do here, we're going to finish this all up together because, you know, why not? And I still have a little bit of design work to do on the outer edge, the lip, if you will. But we will get these top couple of rows here done and out of the way. I hope I have enough here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 3. No, because the last layer, this is going to be the ramps. Yeah, this is going to be, so we have two more rows of these guys. And then we will go to the ramps. Because as soon as these zombies hit this level, I want them to boom fall into that next funnel. And let me just take a peek here real quick. I can't see the house from here. So yeah, that's kind of a shitty thing. I thought about it earlier. Is maybe I should have built this a little bit closer to the base. So we could at least see it at nighttime. But we can always look at it from down there. You know, we got that option as well. Now, I came up with another design in my head. Oh, yeah, this is going to be a fun one. I came up with another design in my head. This one I did not see from a YouTube video suggestion, or not something that anybody else has done, to my knowledge anyway. Not something that somebody else has done. Break. There we go. And after we get through the day 70 horde, I'm going to go ahead and try my new design. That is going to be the next thing. And I will, of course, build it much, much closer to the base because I want to be able to see, it work. And it'll be a lot nicer to have things a little closer to the base because right now, one of the biggest pains in the butt that I had to deal with while doing this whole thing was running all the way from the base all the way over to here. You know, I go down there and I dig and then I have to run all the way through the tunnel, all the way up the ladder, and then run all the way over here. And it was kind of a giant pain in the butt. So I think the next thing I want to build is going to be a lot closer It's going to be a lot closer to the base. I'm not exactly sure where I'm going to build it yet. I've got to play around on my test world and see, you know, where I want to put it. Am I going to have enough of these sons of bitches? Boy, it's going to be close. It's going to be close. It's going to be, like, right on the edge of not having enough of these. I think we're going to have exactly enough, quite honestly. I did not do any math, by the way. No. I had enough math for one day. Come on. People are waiting. Can you place faster? Yes, you can. Such a tedious process. I mean, we're on, let's see, there's 46 rebar frames left, which would mean that we are at 1,500? I think 1,500 rebar frames now total for this whole thing. Somewhere in there. Yeah. And that's not including the ramps or the corners. This is just the straight square rebar frames. Something like 1,500. Plus, I still got to go down there and fix that hole. But I will do that after I go down there and take out all of those wood frames. That's just access for right now. So I got to go up and do the... you know what I should do? Once I get around to that spot there, I need to add to my ladder. Otherwise, I could take some fall damage when I go down there. So we'll finish this row, and then we'll go down and we'll fix that. Okay. So now, where are you? Hey, there you are. Yay. And then let's do that guy. That guy. That guy. That guy. There we go. Perfect. And yeah, like I said, those little... Ooh, 88. Oh, no. Wait, are we there? No, this is exact. Oh, we're going to come up like four short, aren't we? Four short and seven spears ago. Yeah, we're going to come up short. No, we're going to come up more than four. Wait. Oh, I thought I had another stack on me, but I don't. Son of a biscuit. Well, I can always finish that. I can always finish that off camera, but we will at least start getting the ramps in place. And they are, I do have to do some digging out here on this ground level because I want to put in some concrete, you know, just for giggles because I want to make it look nice. That's it. Oh, we're more than that. What are we? How many are we short? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. What did I say? I said 8 short, didn't I? Dang. All right, let's go ahead and get these in place. We can at least get these in place. Then we can go ahead and start putting the ramps in. You'll kind of get a general idea of what's going on here. Oh, 8 short. Son of a biscuit. Don't worry. We're finishing this up today. Ain't no doubt. We may run a little long, kids, but we're finishing this up today. Now, we will test it on the next episode because... obviously, day 70. What I will do is I will shut off all my forges and all that crap. So that way, when it's 2200 o'clock on day 70, I will just stand down there in the bottom of the middle of the whole thing. You know what? In fact, I can go ahead and take this out now. And yeah, so on 2200 o'clock, I would just stand down there in the middle so that the horde will come to me, the horde, and they will all track to this, woo, jeez, they will all track to this place, and it won't be an issue. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to, I'm going to go get some more rebar. I will finish up the top row there, or I will fill this in, and then I will start filling in that top row, and then we will come back so you can see the finished product. So, ow. Stairs will come later. Yeah. Hang on. All right, just finishing this up. I got that little hole there buttoned up, and that's cooking, doing its thing. I got a refill of wood, and thankfully I didn't use much concrete. I did use a lot of wood, but you know, yeah, thankfully I have 44,000 more freaking wood to work with. And this concrete's already curing, which is strange considering how slow it generally cooks. I'm not sure if it's due to daylight heat or whatever. Hell, I don't know. All right. And I do have some corner pieces that I will put in as soon as I can concentrate and do this correctly. There we go. And corners. There we go. I grabbed a few of those. You are that corner over there. And I don't want to go out of order on these. Excuse me? What the? Oh, son of a biscuit. Now you want to be that corner. Okay, you can be that corner. What corner do you want to be now? You want to be that one. All right. Well, I guess we're going to play this game. I hate this damn game. Can they just decide which direction the damn foxholes should point? I mean, really, seriously... It's not that hard. I'm facing a certain direction. Point the damn thing the direction I'm facing. I mean, come on, Madmall. All right. And then all we've got to do is I want to do a little bit of a lip on the outside edge here because this really looks like all hell. Give me my shovel. Oop, no, not my first aid kit. Give me my shovel. There we go. Got it right the second time. Okay. And I want to dig this out a little bit. And now I have seen in other versions that people will put some spikes in here. They will put like this row of concrete in, and then they will do like another ramp facing down towards me. Down this direction, and then there will be a spike, like a wood log spike, that the zombies will get stuck on to give them a little added damage. I'm not going to worry about that too much because I think that between the fall damage and me standing down below shooting the shit at them, I think we're going to be in really good shape. Now, one suggestion that a lot of you did give me was that instead of wood log spikes down there at the bottom, around the perimeter, to use campfires. I think it's a fantastic suggestion. I will say I'm going to do both. What I'm going to do is I'm going to do I'm going to do every other on that. I'm going to do a log spike, then a campfire, and a log spike, then a campfire. And I think the zombies are going to walk around long enough. They're going to get caught by the campfire. They're going to take some damage from the spikes. I think that's going to work out quite well. That was a hell of a suggestion, and I want to thank all of y'all for that one. I had thought about campfires originally, but yeah, I don't know. The only other thing I have to do is I have to go through and light this sucker up from the backside, which I will do with some torches because they're bright, and I'm thinking that the torchlight will shine through the concrete. I'm not sure. If it doesn't, I will switch it out to spotlights, the mobile spotlight things. I have plenty extras of those and plenty more stuff to make them. So, yeah, I definitely want it bright enough that whatever we decide on, that you guys will be able to see this come Horde Night, which is tomorrow night. So get ready for the next episode on that one. Yeah, so we're going to check this out. I'll put in a few campfires, with an appropriate amount of burnable material. down at the bottom. Some log spikes, I will probably only repair them up to the second wood tier. Just, you know, I won't put any scrap iron onto them. I think that's probably the best way to do it. I mean, they're cheap and easy, and I've got a million woods, so I think that's going to do it. So, do me a favor, kids. Please hit the like button if you liked. Subscribe if you're new. And if you are new, please introduce yourself down below in the comments. I would love to meet and tell me what the fudge was that all about. Weird. Yeah, let me know what y'all think in the comments. Yeah, I may extend this lip another block. I don't know yet. Haven't decided. Anyway, we'll see it. We'll see the finished version on Monday. So until then, kids, have a wonderful day, and I will see you next time. Yay, funnel of death. Dun, 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 dun. Funnel of death.